Every part of Liberia, every sector of Liberia was affected by Ebola, not only survivors or victims and family. Ebola was not just a health crisis, but it created a lot of social tension between community members, local authorities in their community, even amongst family members.
When people begin to experience the Ebola crisis, besides the Ebola crisis, there are a lot of tension issues that came about during the Ebola crisis. Youth no longer want to see the health workers in their communities. They no longer want to see security personnel. They went against the health workers. They went against even the district and the county leaders.
Agatha contracted Ebola while working as a volunteer nurse.
Since I got discharged on the 28th of July 2014, I went to the community, but the community did not accept me. They did not embrace me. They stigmatized me. Where I'm walking on the street, they usually point hand on me, saying that that lady is a survivor. That lady is a survivor. So they cannot even come closer to me. Up to now, I'm talking to you.
At that time, the Pine, the OIC are there, having problems with the town people who are not easy cooperating. They are almost at war. In fact, some people are seeing that they wanted to go and point the whole Pine down.
At the time, the police are refusing our money. Even when you move from here, you say, I'm going to TNE. No motorboat driver can take you. They say, can't you that Ebola center? Everybody here get Ebola. So when you move from here, you go in the nearby town, they can't accept you. They can't even get, they see you coming, they will escape.
People think we're receiving funds from donors or NGOs. I have problem with my landlord increasing rates because she feels that we're earning more or we're getting funds from people, getting help from people, which is not so.
There are 18 DPDs. District platforms for dialogue, working in the border communities across Guinea, Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Cote d'Ivoire. They work to rebuild trust within communities.
We are trying to identify conflict generated by the Ebola virus disease, and we try to mediate between key stakeholders as we are involved in the fight.
Health worker Morris had struggled to encourage villagers to return to their local clinic since he was cleared of the virus.
Now, DVD were able to talk to the community people from village to from town to town that they should go back to the clinic. Even though I have returned by working there, they should have no fear. They should continue their daily routine treatment.
Much of the work the DPDs do is around education and mediation.
When the DVD men came in, they introduced themselves to us, and then we welcomed them, and then they start to educate us. They took off from here, they came out in Pujon. We had a meeting with the other community. How to hold a survivor? They were the survivor and I came from the ET, they came back. We must not be afraid of them. We must stay to them, eat with them, encourage them.
The DPD activities has created much impact because they've helped integrate us to the community, reunite us in the community, talk to people in the community, say that these people are cured, they no longer have disease, and there is no tendency for them to transmit anymore. You can play and interact as usual.
This is very timely, and had it been this project, there would have been more tensions and more conflicts in the communities where Ebola actually struck.
Even though a virus gone, we believe it will not come back, but we are affected.
This is a war that you can't see. You can't see the bullet, but a war So I please kindly ask the president if she or her if you must do something for us. All the survivors, I'm talking behalf of them. All the survivors in the country, please you must do something for us.
The issue of reconciliation is not just an event. It takes a lot of time, effort to have people to reconcile with each other.
To bring them together is a long-term process. It's not just one day or one week or one month. We have to continue, and we still have to continue because many people, you go into the rural communities, you talk to them, they will begin to cry because they have a long trauma